your answer? Common arts, common everyday arts should be letter A, appreciated. Number two, it's letter A, appreciated. Very good. Next number, present day has a lot of?
Letter D, ma'am.
Present day has a lot of varieties. Letter D. Number four, manga is an example of? Letter?
Letter D.
Performance art ba?
Visual art, ma'am.
Letter D, visual art. Number five, contemporary arts, an expression of art? Expression of R, lesser C, times. Kasi iba-iba po. Number 5 is letter C. How about number 6? Contemporary arts is the artist's expression of his perception and comprehension of his personal
context, ma'am.
Context. Contemporary arts of the Philippines is diverse as are people. Number 7, people. Number 8, viewers can be appreciated contemporary Philippine art more by employing all their C, senses. Number 8, letter C, senses. And number 9, present day, our art expressions artists should want to do the following known through their culture, issues, situation.
Letter D.
Letter D. And the last one, contemporary Philippine art considered not only an artist, but also the participation of
community through the viewers.
Letter B, community. Opo. Okay, let us proceed for our lesson. I am going to introduce to you some various contemporary art forms. These are the some examples of contemporary art. May tanong ka, Marlon? Ah, wala naman po. Okay po. Balikan po natin mamaya, ha? Okay. These are some examples of researches of various contemporary art forms. Nandito yung ipapakita ko sa inyo yung iba't ibang example ng contemporary form ng arts dito sa ating bansa. So, ito yung Philippine art timeline natin, yung nasa left, yung nasa right naman po yung highlights. Opo, pipicturan nyo lang po yung inyong activity 1, then mamaya po magsesend ako ng link para po doon nyo i-upload yung inyong nasagutan. Okay po? Okay, let us start. The pre-colonial art period begins with 6185 BC to 1520 AD. Nag-start yung pre-colonial art period. This is the old stone Paleolithic age of horticulture, Neolithic period, Metal Age, and Iron Age. Yan yung tinatawag na Philippine art line nila. Yung stone na yan, yan po yung example sa Philippine art time. So ano ba yung highlights dyan sa old stone na yan? So ito po ay galing sa Espinosa Ranch site Cagayan noong 1600s. Recovered from the ranch in site in Cagayan in the province of Tuplake Tools. Dated about 9 million years. So ang tanda na pala ng stone na yan, ano? The oldest man-made object associated with the fossils are proboscidian and prehistoric elephant. Yan yung sample ng stone. Next naman po is the shell bracelet and pendants. Ayan po. Neolithic naman nung panahon na nilabas yan. So yung shell bracelet na yan and pendants, galing naman po sa Cagayan, Palawan, and Sorsogon. Noong 4,854 BC, shell were fashioned into tools as well as ornaments. So, ginagamit siyang quintas, yung shell, mga shell na yan. The oldest known ornaments made from the cone shell were found in early 1960s in the grave of an adult male in Duyung Cave in Palawan. A shell disc with a hole in the center was found next to his right ear, and a disc of hole by the edge was found in his chest. The shell ornaments were dated 4,854 BC. So meron daw isang tao na may suot-suot niyan. Next po natin, Agonoph petroglyphs are the oldest work of art in the Philippines. Ito naman daw po ay located sa province ng Rizal. There are 127 human and animal figures engraved on the rock wall, probably cave during the late Neolithic 3000 BC. So ito daw po, itong work art na to ay nasa province ng Rizal. Doon siya natagpuan. Next naman po, Lingling O. Lingling O naman was found in 200 BC to 200 AD at Duyung Cave, Palawan. A kind of ear of elephant. Nakita nyo po ba? Mukha naman siyang ano, no? Tenga. So, a kind of ear pendant fashioned from the green and bright jade is the characteristic trait of the early metal age. Ito naman yung metal age. One of the finest jade ornaments found to the date is a double-headed pendant recovered from Duyung Cave, Palawan. It is an example of the superb craftsmanship of an ancient carving in jade. So, ito daw po ay nagawa sa jade. Manunggal jar. Actually, we study about manunggal jar, ano? It is a burial jar excavated from the Neolithic burial site in the Manunggal Cave of Tabon Cave at Lipuon Point, Palawan. From 890 to 710 BC, maitong jar naman po is on in metal age 190 BC to 500 AD. In 1991, the National Museum archaeological team discovered anthropomorphic secondary burial jars in Ayub Cave. So ang daming nakikita sa mga kuweba na ganyan, ano, diyan nakalagay yung mga alam niyo yung kinecremate, sinusunog kasi sa kanila yon. Diyan nila nilalagay. Next naman po, Okir. Okir came from the Surigao gold objects. Dated stamp could be placed in the span of 10th to the 13th centuries AD. Pre-Hispanic era naman po ito. Sa pre-colonial traditional art, has religious symbols, everyday activities such as fishing, farming, etc., or specific decorative art pattern in the community. Yan po, tingnan niyo po yung sample nila ng gold, ano? There are also an exchange of art, aesthetics, and art of processes with Chinese and other Asian countries. So, pinagpalit din po ito. Baybayin is the Tagalog ancient script, also known as Bisayan as Badlit. So, yung baybayin po is ang Tagalog ancient script. Tandaan po yung baybayin na yan, ha? So, also known as Bisayan Badlit. Sa Bisaya naman po, ang tawag naman nila, Badlit. It is derived from the Brahmic scripts of India and first recorded in the 16th century. It continued to be used during the Spanish colonization of the Philippines until the 19th century. Baybayin, parang yung alpabeto, yung pagbabasa natin. Next, ito po, sari manok. Other pre-colonial art. So, ito yung mga art natin before. Bago dumating yung film, yung dances, ito muna yung mga art natin. Nandyan yung pottery, weaving, tattoo, jewelry, carving, metal crafts. Yan ang unang-una nating mga arts bago pa dumating yung stage play, a sculpture. Yan po yung una nating mga arts. Unchanged art design. Ito po. The orc here. The motif is an artistic cultural heritage of the Maranaos. So, yung oak here kanina, ito po yun, ha? Ayan po yung oak here. Galing daw po yun sa Maranao. It is an artistic design of the Maranao native inhabitants of southern Philippines, beginning from the early 16th century, before of the Islamization of the area. Okay, there's a design or pattern often rendered on curb in hardwood, brass, silver, and wall painting in curvilinear lines and Arabic geometric figures. Ayan po, kung titignan nyo, no, ang dami niyang curb na yan, no? Ayan po, yung mga curb na yan. Yan po yung sinasabi doon kanina. So, may mga Arabic words pa raw po dyan. Next naman po is the use of the Maranao artist. Ano nga ba yung mga ginagamit ng mga Maranao? Number one dyan ay matilak. Ibig sabihin po ng matilak ay circle. Sunod yung poyok o bud, dapal o leaf, paco o fern or spiral form, todi, fern leaf with spiral and upper edge, paco, lunga, fern leaf with a cut off at one edge. Another elements found by Dr. Madale are naga, obid-obid binotoon, kianoko, at pakonay, and tali-tali. The common theme, ang mga ginagawa daw kagaya ng okor na ito, ang karaniwan po dyan ay torogon known flower, o pwede daw silang mag-engrave ng mga, alam nyo ba yung mga nara na upuan natin? Diba, yung mga artwork nila doon, ang gaganda. Yun po, magandang design ng mga upuan. Spanish colonial art. Kung kanina po, nasa pre-colonial period tayo, ngayon naman po, nasa Spanish period naman po tayo. So, sa Spanish period po, na-introduce naman po yung formal painting. Sculpture, architecture, and was inspired by the Byzantine, Gothic, Baroque, and Rococo art styles. So, sa Spanish colonial period, ito yung mga nag-influence. Sila yung nag-introduce ng painting, ng sculpture, and architecture. Most of the artworks are religious Catholic based. Ayan po. Alam niyo po ba yung mga simbahan? Simbahan natin, ang daming yung ibang lumang-lumang simbahan, ang daming design, di ba? Sa Byzantine period, sa Byzantine painting style, attribute to the Malter of Retire, Battle of Marignano. Okay. Noon pong 1515 yan, yan po yung Byzantine painting styles. Yan yung galing sa Spanish colonial art period. Sa Baroque aesthetics naman po, Cathedral Church naman ang mga nag-uso. So ito yung Cathedral Church of Saint Mary of sa Spain po ito. Ayan. Saint Mary in Murcia, Spain. Yung isa naman po, Maygao. Rococo art naman po yung nasa baba. It is in 18th century naman po, characterized by whimsical curvy lines and elaboratively decorative style, whose the name derives from the French word rocaille, meaning rock work. So karamihan sa mga simbahan, alam niyo ba, sino ba ang nakita na ng simbahan natin na gawa sa bato na makalumang-makaluma na? Saang simbahan kaya ito? Sige, Jude, may sagot ka?
Sa Iloilo, Miagao po.
Saan pa?
Sa Iloilo, Miagao po.
Ah, sa Iloilo. Sa Cebu, meron din po. Ayan, marami. Alam nyo dito sa may Nagcarlan, Laguna, sabi ni Queen Anne. Dito po sa Baraswain Church. Have you seen the Baraswain Church in Bulacan? Yan, isa po yan sa magandang, sa Magdalena, Laguna, sabi ni Vincent. Oh, ito naman po yung Rococo art. Ayan po. Is a Gothic art, is a style produced by the Northern Europe in the Middle Areas. Uprising the Philippine artists, it is the formation, opo, meron din sa San Jose. Formation of the elite Filipino class, the Ilustrado, paved way to reach locals to study the abroad. Just, in that case, a more of academic and Western approach has been learned. O maraming mga Pilipino nag-aral sa ibang bansa para lang po maipakita sa atin yung arts na napag-aralan nila sa ibang bansa. The Filipino classic system is formed that borrows the neoclassicism, romanticism, and even the hint of expressionism. The first Filipino to paint his face, the first self-portrait in the Philippines, father of the Filipino painting, Damian Domingo. Po, si Damian Domingo daw po ang father ng self-portrait in the Philippines. Siya daw po yung father of the Filipino painting. So siya daw po yung kauna-unahang nagpa-paint sa mukha. Siya din yung nag-paint. Narinig po ba ako?
Yes po, ma'am.
Bakit choppy opo daw po ako? Hindi naman po ako choppy?
Medyo choppy, ma'am.
Ah, okay. Sorry. Ayan po. Narinig po ba ako?
Yes po.
Okay. Let us proceed. This is Felix Resurrection Hidalgo, one of the greatest Filipino painters, along with the fellow painter Juan Luna in the 19th century. Dalawa po silang famous na painters, si Juan Luna at si Felix Resurrection Hidalgo. Their work has touch of romanticism and aesthetics of neoclassicism. Ibig sabihin ng romanticism, ang mga gawa nila ay tungkol sa mga simbahan. Ayan. Next, kagaya po nito. This is La Pintura, sa painting by Felix Resurrection Hidalgo. done in the style of Impressionism. The painting depicts a woman holding a paintbrush while turning back the viewer as she gazes towards unfinished canvas. Ayan po. Gawa po ito ni Felix Resurrection Hidalgo. Next painting, sino po ba ang nakakaalala? Napag-arala na po natin ito. Anong tawag po sa painting na ito? Ang painting na to ay pinaint ni Juan Luna. At Polarium, ang title ma'am. Ng painting na ito ay is Polarium. Very good. Next natin. American Colonial Period. Tapos na sa Spanish Period. Punta naman po tayo sa American Colonial Art Period, which begins in 1898 to 1946. The American brought an education and values formation which both the following. American Way of Life by Alice Guillermo. Sining Visual. Art Illustration and Advertising. And Commercial Design gained popularity and incorporated with fine arts. Ayan naman po, marami nang na-introduce sa atin. Portraits are reserved for high-ranking officials with more academic approach to make the subject more formal. So lahat ng paintings na yung mga magaganda, binibili na kagad ng mga matataas na official. Sila na yung nagbabayad kagad-agad. Okay, this is one of the popular style of colonial American colonial period. This is Manila City Hall. It is a neoclassicism architecture. Okay, neoclassicism in architecture, the White House, that is one. Neoclassicism in Philippine architecture is the Manila City Hall. Art Deco in Architecture by Chrysler Building and Art Deco in Philippine Architecture, Metropolitan Theater. Papakita ko po sa inyo. Ayan. Art Nouveau is a style of decorative art, architecture, and designed by the prominent in Western Europe and the U.S. from about 1890. Yung World War One. It is characterized and in intricate linear designs. Ito po, Chrysler Building. Kung kanina, yung Manila City Hall. Okay po, wait lang po. Yan. Yan po yung Chrysler Building. Sunod naman po natin. A Major System Western Europe. Ayan. Ito po yung Metropolitan Theater. Is an art deco. Inspired by United States during 1930s. It is characterized by simple, clean shapes and often streamlined. Look or ornament that is geometric. Nakita niyo po yung parang patayo. Tapos mayroong mga parang painting siya sa taas. Styled from the representation forms and unusually varied. Often expensive materials. Mahal daw ang ginamit ng mga kagamitan dyan. Okay, notable artist Fabian de la Rosa. Fabian de la Rosa, the brightest name in the Philippine painting after Juan Luna. And certainly the leading master of genre in the first quarter of the century. His nephews are artists are well Pablo and Fernando. This is the Brussels Art Nouveau. Next naman po. Ito naman po si Fernando Amorsolo. a portraitist and painter of rural landscape. He is the best known for his craftsmanship and mastery of the use of light. So si Fernando Amorsolo, ang madalas nang ginagamit na medium ay light. His art styles are impressionism, luminism, realism with objects, inspired by the Philippine genre, and the historical nudes and society portraits. He is the first awardee of National Artist in 1972. Fernando Amorsolo. Next, Guillermo Tolentino. Guillermo Tolentino won the National Artist Awards for the Culture in 1973. He is considered the father of Philippine arts. Because of his great works like famous Bonifacio Monument, Filipinos' Cry of Freedom, and the Oblation in UP. Si Guillermo Tolentino, siya po yung stylist o gumawa ng Oblation sa UP. Alam niyo po yung parang sculpture na naka-bold doon sa UP, sa unahan ng UP. Si Guillermo Tolentino po ang gumawa noon. So, ang kanyang model ay si Fernando po Senior. Emergence of the Philippine Pre-Modern Art. Triumvirate of the Philippine Modern Art, Victorio Edades. Have you heard? Di ba napag-aralan na natin tungkol sa kay Victorio Edades? At saka si Carlos Botong Francisco? Okay, kasama rin nila si Galo Ocampo. Introduce the art and style such as pop art. So sila na po ang nag-introduce ng pop art. Maximalism, minimalism, abstraction, expressionism, constructivism, magic realism, realism, and environmental art before the World War II. So yung tatlo na to, si Victorio Edades, si Carlos Francisco, at saka si Galo, sila yung nag-introduce ng mga form of art na yan. The Legend of the 13 Modern Art are Victorio Edades, Carlos Francisco, Galo Ocampo, Hernando Ocampo, Cesar Legazpi, Justado Lorenzo, Vicente Mananzala, Anita, Magsaysayho Demetrio, Diego Ricarte, Purungan Bonifacio, and Cristobal Capilli. Sila po yung 13 modern art. By the way, ibayaan nyo po, isi-send ko tong presentation ko na to sa GC para may reviewer din po kayo. Okay? Next, post-colonial period. O tapos na tayo sa pre-colonial, nandito na tayo sa post-colonial. Nagsimula po ito noong 1946 hanggang 1986. The study of the determining what is the Philippine contemporary art period is still being determined since it has been used loosely even during the American colonial period. Kasi kung hindi dahil sa Spanish period, colonial period, siguro yung ibang simbahan natin, hindi ganun kaganda ang disenyo. However, some Philippine art historians, critics, have always been a follower of the Western art style. It trends at the point that and thus suggested that this was actually the point where Philippine modern art started, but went only full swing only the after the World War. This is the set of creation of the Art Association of the Philippines, or AAP, that in the way has a strong learning with the modernists than the conservatives. Traditional are also termed as Amorsolo school. So, nung unang panahon, hindi ganun siya na bibigyang pansin yung contemporary art. After lang nung digmaan. Etong Cultural Center of the Philippines is the example of the Philippine Modern Art. Ayan po. Sino na po ba ang nakapunta dito sa CCP? Sa Pasay po ito. Okay, next natin. Ayan. Philippine Postmodern Art. The support of the Philippine government for the arts via the creation of the Cultural Center of the Philippines. 1969 gave a venue for all the artists to experiment and explore the different art medium, tying closely to the postmodern art period of the West with pop art, installation art, performance art, dominating the scene. So itong CCP na ito, it contrasts the social realism became a heavy theme by the most Filipino artists as a social commentary of the problem brewing in the Philippine political and social landscape. So binigay sa kanila yan para ayusin, para pagandahin. Lumabas naman po na napakaganda talaga ng Cultural Center of the Philippines. Philippine Contemporary Art in 1980s. Ito na po, yung ngayon na. Ano nga ba yung contemporary art ngayon? It was on the set of the sudden rise of personal computers. Ngayon, makabago na yung contemporary, no? Iba na yung medium nila, yung iba. Digital art na, tama po ba? Technology created a new art, medium of arts, and human expression. But there was and also countless and revivals of the old styles being done. This started in new direction from the arts, the setting the name momentarily, the Philippine Contemporary Period. So ito yung mga nagdaan nating mga contemporary. So madami tayong art. Simula pa lang sa Spanish, sa pre-colonial, sa post-colonial, lahat tayo meron ng art dito sa Pilipinas. Mas nabigyang emphasis lang siya noong natapos ang World War. Okay, next natin. Postmodern art. This is one art. Body part art movements that sought to contradict some aspects of modernism. Or some aspect that emerged or developed in its aftermath. In general, movements such as intermedia, installation art, conceptual art, and multimedia, particularly involving the video, are prescribed as postmodern. Alam nyo, last August, yung eldest ko na nagpunta sila sa Art in Island. Sabi niya, Mama, ang nanong art ay Art in Island. 3D siya. Yun yung kasi yung sample ng art din talaga. Pinapakita niya yung iba't ibang uri ng art. Pag napasyal kayo, try to see Art in Island. There are so many 3Ds there. Mapapakita nila yung iba't ibang art. Opo, maganda at may enjoy nyo dun sa Art in Island. Nakapunta na ako dun dati, pero yung ngayon, 3D na yung ginawa nila. Different classification of art forms. So, sa mga nakita natin, focus on how audience classify arts. Performing arts involves the use of artistic body as the medium of art. Sa performing arts, nandyan yung plays, music, live music, TVs, operas, mimes, puppet shows, acrobatics, dances, and ballet. Yun yung performing arts. Yung visual arts naman po, usually exhibit in two-dimensional forms, stays in one place, something that we see and we hear. Visual. Cultural naman po, a three-dimensional form that we can touch, we can see, and we can climb. Stays in one place. Example niyan ay monuments, architecture, architectural designs, rise terraces, rock gardens, Eiffel Tower, Statue of Liberty, flower garments, water fountains, and buildings. So, meron tatlong classification ng art. Depende yan sa, by the audience, performing arts, visual arts, and sculptural. Okay. Ito yung example ng arts. Ayan. Itong presentation ko na to, isi-send ko sa GC natin. Wait lang po, may isa pa ako ipe-present. Wait lang po ah. Parang mag 1 hour na pala. So yung activity ko na lang po, isi-send ko sa GC natin. Pwede po bang tayong magbukas ng ating camera? Para mag-picture po tayo? Okay ko yung... Wait lang po. Nasaan ako? Bakit may nagpe-present? Wait lang po. Wait lang po, ayusin ko yung aking... There you are. Wait. Bakit wala ako? Bakit may nagpe-present na wait lang? Wait lang po, wait lang. May nagpe... Wait lang po ha. Okay, let us take a picture. May tanong si Shane? Nagre-raise hand siya? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Smile. Okay, wait lang po. Isa pa po? Wait lang, send ko po sa GC muna natin para hindi ko mawala yung picture. Okay, meron po akong activity na isi-send sa GC natin. There you are. Ayan, one more time po. Wait lang po ah. 1, 2, 3. Ayan, ang gaganda ng estudyante ko. Okay, maraming maraming salamat po sa inyong pagpasok for today. Isisend ko po yung link natin kung saan nyo ipapasa yung activity natin kanina. At isisend ko din po yung activity ko, presentation ko na to para may reviewer po kayo. Okay po? Maraming salamat po sa pagpasok. Pwede na po kayong mag-out. Maraming maraming salamat po.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye po. Thank you po.
Good night po.
Bye po, ma'am. Thank you po.
Thank you.
Bye.
Salamat po sa lahat. Pwede na po kayo mag-